Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. More battle mode madness coming up right now, this time with the coin runners that I'm going to be doing the DF stages. What better way to finish this off than to use Princess Pussy in her best form here? I mean, just think about it. Wouldn't it be funny if a girl beat these characters out? I mean, come on, think about it. Anyway, Retro Stages SNES Battle Course 4, here we go. No, thank you. I was like way off there. And here we go.
Beep, beep, beep.
Go, 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 go. Oh, I was a little bit off in my timing, wasn't I? Oh, well. Anyway, the objective of this course is to collect as many coins as you possibly can. As you see, there's a bunch of coins riddled around this place, and yeah, you collect them for your team. If you ever get hit by a thing, you also lose some coins, so be careful not to get hit by things. And that's really all there is to the coin runner thing. It's very similar to the balloon battle in that way, but at the same time, it's, well, not, because of the fact that you can recollect the coins that you lose if you ever drop any. I'm gonna shoot this at King Boo. That did not attract King Boo whatsoever. Curses! Oh wait, I forgot I'm blue, not red this time. Ah, no wonder that didn't attract it. Ah, that's what I get for doing two of these things at the same day. You get used to the red and then, yeah. Anyway, so let's just keep collecting the coins. More and more coins appear on the track as you go as well. And it appears we're doing fairly well this time around, even though the red computer seems to be collecting a bunch of coins here. And that's okay, I guess. Once I knock some computers around, things will be good in the end. Well, at least I hope so. I'm going to zoom around here and just keep collecting coins. I would actually recommend staying away from other characters for the fact that... Oh god, there's blue shells in this? I forgot about that! Well, that's not good. Well, okay, I'm good to go, I guess. But, yeah, you want to hoard your coins as best as you possibly can. That should probably be on the outer track, shouldn't I? Well, maybe not. There's a coin there anyway. I think it would be faster to get the coins on the inside than they would be for the outside. You know, the way that they're positioned. So that's what I think I'm going to do, if at all possible. Red computers, I would really like to battle you guys for... Oh, that was so close! So very close. Oh, that would have been so awesome. Woo! I got a coin, yay! I almost cut him off in the pass. Maybe I could get those couple of coins around that corner before they disappear. I would doubt it, though. Yeah, it's not looking... Oh god, oh god, oh god! Shell shield! I think we're gonna win this one. It's looking pretty good at this moment. Hopefully things will keep going in my favor. If I have to, I'll bump into some red computers. Oh no! That is blasphemy, and now we are losing. That is a bad thing, and it's coming near the end of the thing. And we are pretty far ahead, too. So that kind of sucks in a way, but oh well. Things just happen. I got 8 coins, though, at the end of this, even though I got hit by a couple things. I did the best of my entire team! What the heck happened to my team? Okay, I don't blame myself this time, I blame my team. Next battle! And I end up crying like a little girl. Both literally and figuratively. Anyway, Game Boy Advance Battle Course 3, here we come. The Game Boy Advance and the SNES courses have a really, really similar feel to them. Because, you know, they were built on the same engine. You know, I shouldn't say the same engine. They were built with the same system specs. Like, the Game Boy Advance was pretty much as powerful as the SNES, and I was way off my timing there. Curses! But, yeah, you get the idea. So, they were both limited in the amount of graphics that they could produce, so they both looked pretty much the exact same as the other one. Well, not exactly the same, but you get the idea. They both had the same flat feel to them. And why did I shoot that shell behind me? I am being an idiot. Anyway, hopefully I'll be able to win this with the great greatest of ease compared to the other one, even though I kind of was doing pretty well, or I should say our team was doing pretty well, and shell, aw, come on, it was right there, how could I possibly miss that? That's a total disappointment. So I'm going to use my shell shield and hopefully ram into a bunch of people, preferably Wario. Oh, or Daisy. Wait, someone, I would like to hit someone. By the way, you can tell how many coins a person has when you approach them and you can see their stack of coins. So, yeah. Anyway, looking for more coins. I see a couple here, so I'm just going to pick them up gracefully and completely lose them. As you can also see the coins on the map, and did I miss the coins somewhere on... Did I, like, circle around them and I didn't see them at all? I don't know. Oh, whatever. I think we'll be fine this battle, or at least I hope so. And I shot my shells right at Wario as he was turning big, of course. But they missed anyway, so it didn't matter, so blah. Baby Luigi, cough up some coins. Oh, my shells are coming so close! And I'm getting bombarded by other people's shells. That's just a dandy. And Inky, oh, someone collected that coin. Curses! I can shoot this at... I was gonna say, shoot that at Waluigi, but for whatever reason, it went over to Wario. I don't know why, I was pointing right towards him. That made absolutely no sense. But whatever. That works for me, I guess. This is a high-scoring game, I have to say, this one. Just take a look at the score right now, 35-20 as opposed to the other game. Maybe there's a lot more coins to be had in this stage than there were in the other one. And again, our team is losing coins quickly at the last minute here, which is gonna suck at the end. Oh. Here, have a bomb. That's gonna miss everyone because they all kind of like double back there. It doesn't hurt your teammates, that's why I just fired it in the middle of everyone. Or at least I don't remember it hitting my teammates. If it did, that would have really sucked. But the only reason why I fired it in that group of players there was because I thought it hit the... thank you. I timed it correctly that time and I was able to keep myself from spinning off too much, but I still lost my items. And we're gonna lose anyway, horrendously. I got 6 coins this time around. Again, I did better than my entire team. What the poop. next stage. this is looking to be a complete and total sweep. That's something that I should mention here that I find kind of funny is that people seem to be bashing me for my low skill level in this game for some reason. I don't understand why. I mean, you don't expect that I'm going to be good at every single game that I play, do you? I mean, that would be ridiculous. I'm not a master of all games out there. I'm just a gamer. Typically, I play the games that I'm best at, but in this case, I thought I would do something different. Because of the fact that I'm better... I shouldn't say better. I'm quite good at most Mario Kart games, better than the computers and... better than the computers and most of them. But the fact that this game has a much higher luck factor than other Mario Kart games kind of offsets the fact that I have decent skill in them. So it's more of like playing roulette than it is a normal Mario Kart game. Like any other Mario Kart game, I have no trouble sweeping the computers. But this one? Oh no, I get demolished time and time again. No matter how far ahead I am at the time. So that's why I thought this one would be interesting, because of the fact that, you know, you don't know if I'm going to win or lose like I do on other games. You know, it's more unpredictable than other games in my walkthrough series, I should say. Like, you know I'm gonna beat any game that I come across. Well, in Mario Kart, well, specifically this one, as I said, you just don't know if you're gonna win or lose, whether you know the tracks well or you don't, so... Yeah, you either have to have a lot of luck or you're some extreme natural at this game to be consistent enough to win, like, first place every single time. And I can't see that many people doing that. As a matter of fact, this game was critiqued many times in its past for its high luck factor. So, Excuse me, so that's why I picked it. I thought it would be a little bit more unpredictable than other walkthroughs, and I thought it would be a little more interesting to watch because of it. But evidently that's not the case for some people, but oh well, I guess you can't please everyone. I just make these things for fun anyway. So it looks like our team is doing well, but every time I say that, we get destroyed within the last minute. And that's... the green shells, you have to aim. I come so close to them, but they're all missing for me. It is unbelievable. Seriously. Anyway, I'd like to double back here and collect some of the coins that I missed. Well, that would have been my teammate, so that would have been bad if that person would have collected the coin anyway. And Waluigi or Funky Kong, you're going to take some coinage loss. And I'm going to collect your pocket change if at all possible. Oh boy, we're losing ground here already. See, I shouldn't have said anything earlier, and now we're gonna lose. Well, possibly. I don't know, that's the unpredictable aspect here. So, yep, we're looking for someone in the red. That's gonna fail. Red. Oh yeah, coin stealage, and I actually managed to win one. Well, I should say our team actually managed to win one. Yay! Well, that's because our team actually did good there that time. Well, so that works for me. Next battle, here we come. Loading, curse you! I hate you so much, I don't have the patience for you. Ah! Okay, here we go. And the GameCube Cookie Land, this one is yet another circular track. Just like the other ones in the Wii tracks. But this one does have a little more obstacles in the form of those tri-colored things. Like, you got that bluish green thing off to the left, the pink one off to the right, the yellow one off in the back, and the reddish one in the center to kind of separate the characters, such as the SNES battle stages in a way. So, yeah, you get the idea. It's got the 3D aspect of newer tracks, such as the newer battle modes, but it's got the flat general roundness of the old, well, I should say flat general area and simpleness of the older tracks. It's okay, not one of my favorites because of that. Because I would think like a newer track they would want to put more into it, and the retro tracks they would want to keep the original feel of them, but I don't know. You know, I'd like to separate them. That's just how I feel, man. That's just how I feel. Hopefully my green shell will hit something. My green shell is not hitting. Wait, did my green shell actually hit Waluigi? I can't believe it. I seriously can't believe it. I am astounded beyond belief. That's all I can say. Because my green shells are not landing anywhere. And Baby Peach. Oh, so close. So very close. And I got a Bob on here, so I'm just going to chuck that behind me and hope it knocks some people over. I think I'm gonna start taking the inside track now, because I think all the coins are pretty much cut out of the outside track. But then again, it might be a little safer on the outside. Yeah, maybe I'll stick to the outside. I missed a coin there. Curses! I'm not collecting a lot of coins this one, am I? Maybe I will on the last minute or so of the game when the tension gets a lot more intense thanks to the upbeat music increase, beats per minute, whatever you want to call it. They speed it up, make it all like more exciting. But I think it would be quite doubtful, and I didn't see that shell coming before it was too late. That's sad. And all the coins I have a chance at getting, they're just getting swept like right before my eyes. And that's quite bad. Like that. And yeah, I'm doing quite horrendously this one. Coinage! Yay, I got one! Can I hit someone with something? That would be pretty preferable, in my opinion. There's a bunch of coins around that landed in this area, or maybe they all got picked up already, I don't know, but Baby Luigi, you're gonna get hit by my shell. Hopefully I can offset this game at the last second here. Daisy took a hit there, thanks to me. Oh boy, I don't know if we can pull this off in 24 seconds. But it doesn't matter how this goes, I'm still gonna show the last track regardless of the outcome of this, so yeah. I don't really care about the outcome all that much, honestly. So, yeah, it's all about the fun, as I said, just to show off the game. And, yeah, that's it, I guess. Wait. Our team had the lead just like for a brief second there, and yeah, I did horrendously that one. Wario did pretty good there. So I'm gonna go over to the next track, just like skip through the losing screen here, and the, that's about it there. I'm sorry, Princess Pussy.
Let's go.
Alright, this time I've got Peach on a motorcycle, and I'm gonna go to the DS Twilight House. Probably one of the most blind battle arenas ever, because of the fact that everything's separated by walls in this Luigi's Mansion-style house here. It's probably more based off of a ghost house in like Super Mario World or something like that, or New Super Mario Brothers. You get the idea, but yeah. Just missed that coin completely. I just don't feel like going back for it, honestly. I was hoping to put that red character there, but yeah, I still ended up being on the blue team regardless, somehow, after restarting the game. I don't know how that worked, but I'm not gonna complain, because, you know, I already got myself set up for the... I didn't mean to hit you, blue character. Anyway, I didn't want to, like, lose my routine of hitting red characters after getting used to hitting red characters, even though I thought hitting red characters kind of poorly. You get the idea. So let's just hope for a victory this time in this very spooky house that doesn't seem to have any ghosts in there whatsoever, so it's not all that spooky. It's more of just like a abandoned mansion that needs some repair, and especially a roof of some sort. Unless the Twilight House is the thing in the center, but I did not see any doors to enter that center area anywhere around this place, so I don't know how you're supposed to enter the Twilight House. For all I know, this is the Twilight House here. Rosalina, oh, my shell hit the wall, and that makes me sad. And what coin it? I'm searching around here for coins. I'm trying to get over to where the coins are as they pop up, and I'm kind of failing. But at the same time, I'm kind of hoarding my coins well. But the other time, my teammates aren't doing all that well again. Unless I'm supposed to be hitting more computers along the way, but I haven't really had much opportunity to do so. And that's all I can really commentate about. I mean, come on, this is battle mode we're talking about here. It's just blow up the opponent, collect coins, or save your balloons. You get the idea. So this is more of a thing of, hey, let's just show it off rather than give a walkthrough on it, because there's no, like, real strategy of sorts to win these things every single time, as with any multiplayer thing. So, yeah. Just enjoy the ride, I guess, and wow, we've got 42 coins somehow. How in the holy name of poop did that happen? Where did this quick cycle of victory come from? I don't know. But unless the red computer start hitting us, and I'm gonna just try and hoard my 15 coins here, I think we're gonna win this one pretty easily. Maybe, oh god, we're losing coinage. Where'd those come? I don't know where those came from. But I would like to double back and collect some. Yay! I see your coinage, I see your coinage! Gimme! Yeah! 19 coins, I can definitely live with, oh boy! Live with that, and 7 seconds, keep myself safe. Stay away from peeps. No, not the blue shell, anything but the blue shell! Yeah, finished! That was quite a sweep. Wow. Anyway, now what I'm gonna do is explain how to unlock the game. Unlock all the characters in the game here. A lot of people kept asking me, for whatever reason, like they didn't have faith that I was going to explain how to unlock all the characters later or something like that. I always, like, explain stuff later on the walkthrough, like, to finish things up. So, this is it right now. Like, if you're too impatient to wait for me to explain things, you can always find the answers to all of your game needs on GameFAQs.com. Whenever I say the name GameFAQs.com, I mean GameFAQs dot, also known as a period, COM, and yeah, just search for the game you want, and then go to Cheats, Codes, and Secrets, cheat codes and secrets, excuse me, or just look at the frequently asked questions guides, stuff like that, or even ask at the forums. You'll get your answer far quicker than you would in a by waiting for me waking apart or even asking in the comments. Anyway, I've got all the characters alphabetized here on how to unlock them, so let's go through them right now. Baby Daisy. 1 star, all the 50cc Wii Cups to unlock her. Baby Luigi here. Unlock 8 expert staff ghost data in the time trials. In the time trials, there's a whole other set of things that you can do as opposed to the Grand Prix, which I'm not going to cover here, is that you can beat the staff ghosts of the game, which are the creators of the game's best times. You'll unlock them as you get better and better in the time trial tracks, and then, yeah, that's basically it. What am I saying and then for? That's it. Anyway, Birdo! Play time trials on 16 different courses or win 250 Wi-Fi matches. Bowser Jr., 1 star, all the 100cc retro cups. Diddy Kong, complete the retro 50cc cups. Dry Bones, win the 100cc leaf cup. I don't know where they came up with that calculation, but whatever. Because the other ones are like 1 star or, you know, you get the idea, whatever, yeah, blah, 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 blah. Dry Bubbles, which is this one that I haven't unlocked, that question mark over there. 1 star, all the 150cc Wii Cups, which is something that I was far too lazy and I don't have the tolerance to do myself. So I just never got around to unlocking Dry Bowser. Funky Kong, unlock 4 expert staff ghosts in the time trials. King Boo, win the 50cc Star Cup. Outfit A of the Mii is win the 100cc Special Cup. Outfit B of the Mii is unlock all 32 expert staff ghosts in time trials. You don't have to beat them, you just have to unlock them. Rosalina, where are you? Oh, there we go. Passed you right up. Have a Super Mario Galaxy save file and she will be unlocked after 50 races or get 1 star in all 8 mirror mode cups. Needless to say, I got it with the Super Mario Galaxy method. And finally, Toadette, play time trials on all 32 different courses or win 1,000 Wi-Fi matches. If I were you, I would play the time trial method. I mean, seriously, 1,000 Wi-Fi matches? That would take forever and a half. And you're going to want to play the staff ghost anyway. But anyway, that's it for this walkthrough. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next walkthrough. I hope this answered your questions on how to unlock characters.